Joining us now to discuss the president's handling of the record partial government shutdown, GOP financier Dan Palmer out here in California. Dan, the soundbite from that Coast Guard wife was from out here in California. You can say, look, you know, they're going to get their pay back. It doesn't really matter. The optics of this are going to begin to get tough for Republicans.
In the Senate, you know, I mean, the back door to this whole debate is being held by Mitch McConnell. He's got three Republicans, Collins up in Maine, McSally appointed in Arizona, Cory Gardner in Colorado. They're all in purple states. And I think they're really the weakest part of the Republican caucus in Congress. As long as Mitch can hold the line in the Senate and not take up these individual spending bills, there's time for this political debate to take place.
Earlier, Congressman Francis Rooney of Florida said that he felt bad for the president. It seems as though this is exactly the debate the president wants for his base.
Well, look, his whole campaign began with a call for the wall, and in fact, he won in great part because of his position on this wall. Meanwhile, you've got Nancy Pelosi's new majority in the House. They were elected to resist Trump. That's a broader mandate and perhaps affords her more room to negotiate, but at present, she's unwilling, obviously recently elected as the leader. I think that the issue really is going to have to percolate for a little bit further. The factual subtext is harder for the Democrats. They're arguing the wall doesn't work. The wall costs too much. The wall is immoral. Meanwhile, we have police officers being shot and illegal immigrants aiding and abetting the suspects in these things. So, you know, there's the factual subtext isn't helping the Democrats.
Yeah, but are Republicans winning the factual subtext argument? They seem to be going more for the emotional argument.
No, I'd say the reverse. I think the Democrats are going for the emotional argument. I think the summary argument for the Republicans is, do the Democrats care more about defeating President Trump than they care about helping the American people?
Interesting argument to make. The end of 2018 for the midterms, much of the closing argument by the Republicans and by President Trump was about immigration. And then we know Republicans lost 40 houses in the seats. Say whatever you want about voter turnout, et cetera, but there's no pictures on a scorecard, and that was the closing arguments.
Well, in California, there were 10 seats that were contested. And of those 10, the Democrats had won one on Election Day and then won the rest in the post-election harvesting of votes. So, you know, we had a very effective Democratic ground game fueled in great part by Bloomberg's last-minute $2 million a district investment. It's hard to say that the president lost the argument, but it's unequivocal to say the Democrats won the ground game.
Bring it back to where you started. The president was elected to build the wall. If Nancy Pelosi holds firm to her line the day that she was sworn in as speaker, not $1 for the wall, what does that mean for 2020 and the president's reelection? Are donors going to open their pocketbooks for a guy who couldn't get the one signature item done?
I think he really is faced with a tough choice. He'll probably have to go to declaring a national emergency because he's not going to get what he wants from Nancy Pelosi, at least not now and probably not for a while. So I think if he goes to a national emergency, he'll either succeed in the courts, in which case he's a hero to his base, or the courts beginning in the Ninth Circuit here in California are going to overturn the decision, and then it'll, you know, ultimately if he fails to survive a court test, I think the base will be really angry at the courts, and rightfully so.
All right. I'm sure that is an argument you will use on some fundraising calls. And the group of 2020 hopefuls probably makes those start even earlier. Dan Palmer in Los Angeles. Dan, good to see you.